This video segment is part of a set of videos on basics, in which we'll touch on just the bare essentials of laser measurements you might need to do, and the tools that'll help you do them. In this short video, we'll review how one goes about measuring laser beam power, so that you'll have a clear basic understanding of what the different sensor types are, and when you'd use each type. Our discussion will stay on a general level. For specific help with a solution for your application, please speak to your Ophir representative or make use of the many resources available on our website, such as the Sensor Finder tool and the range of tutorials and training videos. In general, a laser power measuring instrument consists of a sensor and a meter. The sensor is the front end, which receives the laser beam and generates some sort of electrical signal that represents its power. The meter processes and outputs the result, for example, as a numeric display that a human user can read. The choice of sensor is physical. It depends on physical characteristics of the laser beam being measured, while the choice of meter depends on the functions you need performed with the results of your measurement. In this video, we'll focus on the range of Ophir laser power sensors. First, we'll have a general look at the various types of sensors, so you'll know where to start. While energy is the capacity to get a certain fixed quantity of work done, for example, 1 joule of energy is the energy required to raise the temperature of about 0.25 grams of water by 1 degree Celsius, power, on the other hand, is a rate of flow of energy. 1 watt, for example, is 1 joule per second. We can measure power for CW beams, continuous beams, as well as for repetitively pulsed beams. On the other hand, we can talk about measuring the energy of a single pulse, for example. The choice of sensor depends on a number of parameters, including 1, the order of magnitude of power. For example, a sensor that can measure picowatts will probably be vaporized into plasma by a multi-kilowatt industrial beam, while a sensor able to measure multi-kilowatt beams will not likely respond at all to a few picowatts. Spectral region. Different materials absorb light of different wavelengths to varying degrees. And beam diameter. For very low powers, from picowatts up to several hundred milliwatts, we normally use photodiode sensors. These are based on semiconductor detector elements, where light is converted directly to electrical current, which is then measured. Ophir offers several types for different spectral regions and different power levels. For powers ranging from milliwatts and up to tens of kilowatts, we usually use thermal sensors. These sensors absorb the light and first convert it to heat. The heat flows through the sensor and is in turn converted to an electrical signal, which is then measured. The specific selection depends on the details as before: power level, spectral region, beam size, and other parameters of the laser beam being measured. No need to panic. Ophir offers a tool called the Sensor Finder, which does most of the thinking for you and offers the correct solutions for your laser. You can find it on our website. And of course, your local Ophir representative will be more than happy to help you with your particular application. We hope this short video will help put things in order for you, so you'll know how to begin and what questions to ask. In separate video segments, we'll look with a bit more detail at each of the specific sensor types.